Sarah, affectionately known as Fergie, celebrates her birthday today. The Duchess of York turns 62 and, if her former shindigs are to go by, will likely celebrate in style. The birthday wishes have already started to roll in on social media. Warm messages from the royal family and her daughters, Princesses Beatrice and Eugenie, are likely to follow later today. Fergie will have only recently celebrated the wedding anniversary of her youngest daughter, Princess Eugenie. Beau married Jack Brooksbank on October 12, 2018 in an intimate ceremony. Weddings are hallmark events in the family, welcoming a new and exciting chapter. They're also a moment for the family to get together and catch up, a rare thing for people who are as busy as they are. This is why, when Prince William failed to invite Fergie to his 2011 royal wedding to Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, many recoiled. Royal experts like Catherine Olster have claimed it was part of a longer-standing royal rift, dating all the way back to Prince Charles distancing from Fergie following Princess Diana's tragic death in 1997. She said the cousinly bond between William, Beatrice and Eugenie was strong up until this point, but faltered shortly after. Writing in the Mail in 2016, Ms. Olster claimed it all culminated in William failing to invite Fergie to his wedding despite having handed her daughters and countless other royals RSVPs. She claimed, regardless of their mother TMS actions, Beatrice and Eugenie could certainly be forgiven for agreeing with those who thought it a little small-minded of William, who controlled the guest list, to so humiliate her. Sarah is thought to have been extremely upset about not being invited to William's wedding. She watched both William and Prince Harry grow up. Don't miss, she and Diana were also the best of friends for years. Both of them had entered the royal family as outsiders, and so became natural allies in the face of any adversity. And they had, in fact, known each other before becoming part of the firm. They were fourth cousins and moved in the same social circles. However, they fell out in late 1996. While Fergie claimed not to know why, many believed that Diana was angry with the way the Duchess depicted her in her book. Diana sadly passed away in a car accident the following year. The pair never had the chance of reconciling their friendship. Sarah later told Harper's Bazaar, "Because we were like siblings. We rode. And the saddest thing, at the end, we hadn't spoken for a year. I tried, wrote letters, thinking whatever happened didn't TMT matter, let's sort it out. And I knew she TMD come back. In fact, the day before she died she rang a friend of mine and said, we're TMS that red. I want to talk to her. Charles is allegedly overly keen on Fergie. A source told Ms. Osler that he cannot even stand the mention of her name. According to a royal commentator, members of the royal family and Buckingham Palace are allegedly concerned that any virtual conversation between them and Prince Harry could be transcribed, recorded, and presented to media outlets. As there is a strong interest in the relationship between the Sussexes and the royals, the Queen has reportedly been advised that personal conversations could become the target of tappers. Royal commentator Neil Sean claimed, a very good source tells me that the reason why they simply dare not reach out to him, and they truly do want to see if he's all right, how's he coping, you know, these are the people that have known him for years. They know his personal problems, the situations that he has, but they daren't reach out simply because they do not know if anything could be transcribed, recorded, and presented to the world as another story. Now we're not suggesting that everything that Harry and Meghan do does have a monetization attached to it, but isn't it a shame that it's come to that? A lot of people say, oh no, it couldn't be like that, but if you remember, way back when they decided to megxit, it was alluded that Meghan Markle would call in from Canada for the discussions, and if you also remember, Her Majesty the Queen very quickly slapped that idea down, simply because she was advised that that personal conversation could get into the wrong hands. We're not suggesting from Harry and Meghan, but you never know with tappers. She said she had spoken to the couple following their televised tell-all, and said, Harry has talked to his brother and he has talked to his father, too. The word I was given was that those conversations were not productive, but they are glad they at least started a conversation. Prince Harry has publicly spoken about his rift with the royal family on a number of occasions and has criticized his royal relatives for their total neglect in dealing with his and Meghan's mental health. Allegations included the royal family denying their son a title and security, refusing to acknowledge Meghan's mental health, and that a senior member had made a racist remark about their unborn son. The damaging accusations caused a PR crisis for Buckingham Palace, with the Queen releasing a statement to say that whilst recollections may vary, the couple remained much loved members of the royal family. He also told Oprah in the Apple TV Plus series The Me You Can't See, that he would never be bullied into silence again. Relations between the Sussexes and the royal family are reportedly still tense, despite Prince Harry returning to the UK on two occasions in recent months. Whilst the Duke claimed that he and the Queen have a really good relationship and a good understanding, his relationship with Prince Charles and Prince William reportedly remains strained. The two brothers displayed a united front during the funeral of Prince Philip and the unveiling of Diana's statue, and were seen talking and laughing. However, reconciliatory talks behind closed doors have reportedly been unproductive. It is unclear when Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are next due to return to the UK. The couple currently reside in Montecito, California, with their two young children. Meghan has not seen her royal in-laws since the couple's final official engagements in March 2020. 8. Duchess of Cambridge attended the premiere for the new James Bond movie, No Time to Die, last night alongside her husband Prince William, and his father Prince Charles and his wife Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall. While at the much-anticipated premiere, Kate stepped out on the red carpet in a bespoke structured gold gown from Jenny Packham, which a royal expert has claimed is unequivocally the most striking and glamorous get-up she has ever worn, and sent royal fans into a frenzy. Daniela Elza from Australian News Corp News.com.au compared the dress to one the Duchess had worn by the same London designer to the Spectre premiere in 2015, which she described as being a meek, shrouded and pastel frock compared to this year's TMS equivalent of a sartorial roar. She stated the gold glittering getup from this year wasn't TMT just a dress. This was a declaration of intent and a very apparent power move on Kate TMS part. She said, "This frock was a very audible statement, which, to channel the goopy argo of the Sussexes trademark California, about Kate stepping into, and owning, her power." Fans took to Twitter to share their enthusiasm for the getup, with many declaring phrases such as "love her dress," "wow" and "outstanding." User Akayla Adams underscore, who describes themselves a royal watcher and enthusiast, described the ensemble as iconic, complete with flame emojis, while at Principus R90 wrote "goddess in gold" and at Keza96717823 added "outstanding, she is the apex of class, style and sophistication, as well as beauty. Like her mother-in-law, a true icon." Another user, Dancing Infinite One, wrote, "I can TMT handle how perfect she looks," a sentiment which seemed to echo as at BellSimon16 wrote, "thriven and slaying. Real royalty." Another user, J7, enchanneled song lyrics by writing, "goddess on a mountaintop, burning like a golden flame, the summit of beauty and love, and Catherine is her name. She's got it. Yeah baby, she's got it." Follow for live updates about the royal family.